The Money. It was produced by, I think it was produced officially by the Rydberg Museum and Eberhard, but I believe it was his own funds, and there must have been something from some Swiss culture fund or something like that. It was not nearly enough to finish the film. Probably 40-ish.
I'm sure Mrinal might not know the...
I don't know the...
the numbers in any case.
But it was, yeah, it was just about enough to put together. Say again? Oh, this is not meant to recover anything at all. But it will be shown at festivals, and there's a... I imagine there's a small section of people who find this kind of work interesting and like to watch it and enjoy it.
In the context of what were the discussions that you had
with the director?
Any stories that come to your mind?
So everything came from that article of B.N. Goswami, actually. Every little detail, the film begins with a dedication to him, which is, it's very appropriate. That article, in that he kind of draws this story, because all they have is these maybe 20, 50, I can't remember the number, but a certain number of paintings, and even over some of them there might be a controversy whether this is really Nansuk's painting or not. Once you get into the nitty-gritties of the art world, it's a very murky thing, so there'll be people fighting, this is really Nansuk and this is not really Nansuk, and this little gesture on the painting proves that it is his and not. And so B.N. Goswami and Eberhard Fischer, their lives are kind of, they've got 50 years of work in that. And every little thing in the painting, every little stroke is analyzed, every prop, every, you know, thing, every, the way a certain cloth is falling, there'll be a whole thesis, PhD thesis that could be written about that. And so that's the storehouse of information from where the visual and probably not the oral construction, but definitely the visual construction came from there. So a lot of it, to answer your question, would come because Eberhard was there during the selection of the locations. So you go to locations and is it relevant, is it not relevant, is the shape of the arch the right shape of the arch? I mean, these are things which you and I won't even be sensitive to. Is the brick in the wall the right brick for that time? Or not? Because you're trying to come up with locations which might not even exist today. A lot of them might be fictional, like somebody who's a expert in Kathak might come and tell you that, oh, this way of doing it didn't even come till the 19th century, so it can't be right for this. But that's not really the point, you know, it's about creating a world of a certain kind in today's context. So a lot of the initial construction would have come from Eberhard and his understanding, which is what I meant when I said that Amit had to empty himself completely and fill himself up with Eberhard's knowledge. And it was really, in a sense, I remember in some early discussion, he even said as much. He said, this is, you know, Eberhard's film. So no decision would get taken without Eberhard, you know, being part of it. All the properties were made by him, all the costumes, the casting, the faces. It's very interesting, once you see the faces really carefully in the paintings, they're very distinctive features. You won't see those features in the urban cities. You won't see those features amongst you and me. They're very typical to a certain region of India. And so finding those people with those exactly those same features, and they've done a really lovely job of finding people with, you know, a certain kind of nose, certain kind of jawline. So, you know, those kind of small, this kind of, you know, the haircut is still a simpler thing. You can, you know, shave off there. Finding someone to play Nansuk, that was an enormous thing. So Manish Soni, who plays Nansuk, comes from a lineage of miniature painters. His father and his grandfather is a very, very well-known miniaturist called Badrinath Ji, and they're based in Rajasthan somewhere, and have been doing this for generations. So for someone to play that, who has the kind of sagacity and quietude to be able to play that, even casting someone like that, so all of these things would kind of, that's how the initial pictures were built, from, you know, casting, location. And then it was quite simple after that, because we had a painting and we had a narrative in the article. And this happened and this happened and this happened, and then first he left home. First you see the scenes of his home, then he left home, and then he was employed by Zorawar Singh, who died, and then his patron was Balwant Singh, and he started painting for Balwant. So you had all these stories of his life. And so we had all these paintings and the stories of his life. And then we would take each painting and go to the location and see, okay, now what can you do? How much time do we have here? there's going to be no sun. There's sun, it'll look nice, yeah, let's do this. And so it kind of, the thing would get created as we went along, a little bit over the recce, a little bit on the shoot, and you're just trying to create a cinematic narrative using your tools of the cinematic medium, light, sound, editing, you know, that kind of stuff. Sometimes you're just playing around. There's a lot of, Amit, it's impossible for him to completely suppress that tendency that he has to play with the medium. You know, he has to, and you see it throughout the thing. You know, he'll do something silly or something like that. There's always a joke involved in something. It's very witty sometimes. Sometimes it's just very idiosyncratic to how he feels the medium, the way, in his cutting, very often there's a certain kind of, you know, playfulness in his cutting. So then he would kind of do that, and then the sequence would get made, and you'd shoot it. And it was quite, it was a very interesting process.